Air route liberalisation is a very sensitive issue in Africa. It's something that other regions and continents have dealt with in fairly different ways. At a recent conference, however, airlines debated what further liberalisation of the continent's airways would mean for their bottom line. CCTV's Angela Coppola was there.
In fact, there is an agreement going back a decade that African countries signed signalling their intent to liberalise the airways and air channels in Africa. It's not been implemented. Despite this, the air travel sector is growing.
And we're starting to see, we've seen direct investment by China here in Africa. We're starting to see that generating air cargo. And also passenger travel is doing very well in Africa, much better than the global average. Again, particularly with Asia, but also with the Middle East.
The big challenges facing Africa are fairly obvious. Consider that it takes no less than 3 flight changes to get from South Africa to the Central African Republic. The reasons are apparent to some operators.
The issue, like I mentioned, is that national carriers that are giving distorted information to the leadership, and I think more and more the leaders are realizing that they should not be looking too narrowly, they should look, have a broader vision.
IATA's Brian Pierce takes a slightly different, less controversial view.
I think it's commercial freedom. I think we're still seeing too much interference from government in many ways. There are still too few services that are able to fly across the continent within because of regulatory restrictions, and also people want the infrastructure that is useful for customers, for passengers, for shippers. And I think we need to see better consultation on the construction of infrastructure and the use of infrastructure.
Despite the lack of continental government implementation, the passenger segment of the airline industry in Africa has grown by 7%, while the global average is just 4%. The same applies to the cargo business.
Mergers and acquisitions have been touted as a solution to regional airline cooperation on the continent, but they're fraught with regulatory challenges. Perhaps it's time for governments to get out of the way and allow those airlines to get on with business. I'm Angelo Coppola for CCTV in Cape Town.